Hey guys, welcome back and thanks for joining me for another fun experiment on playing with rain. Today we are going to mix Gobstoppers with some water and see what happens. What you need for this experiment are, of course, some Gobstopper candies, a plate to put the water on, and some lukewarm water. So let's go ahead and get started. To begin with, we're going to grab our Gobstopper candies and we're going to put these in kind of a cluster of three on the plate, so you kind of want to sort them by color. And I'm going to do that here. We want to have about three green ones. And you want to put them kind of arranged in a group there, three on that side. There's an orange. We've got a yellow here. We've got a couple purples we'll put off to this side. There's another yellow. Now I need to look for some more colors in here. I've got a lot of green, but I need some other ones. Here's some reds we're going to put here on this side. And what else can I get? Another purple. Slide those over. We need some yellow right here. And now I just need, I'm getting there. I need a couple more. Here's a red. That'll be great right there. And I need a couple more orange ones, and then we'll be all set if I can find them. They're a little bit harder to find. Ooh. Well, there goes a mess. All right. So now that we have our Gobstoppers arranged on a plate in groups of three, I sorted out each color, the green, red, purple, orange, yellow, into about three in each group. And we're going to put them close to the rim of the plate on the outside edge, and then carefully pour this water. This is just room temperature water that I'm going to pour into the plate, and we're going to just slowly and carefully do this. You want to have enough water to where it covers about half of the candy. The bottom half of the candy you want to be covered with water to start to see this reaction happening. Right now, pretty boring, right? There's not much going on. It's a very slow process. Initially, this process takes a little while to really start interacting. And that's because there's a little bit of wax. There's a wax layer on the candy. But once that starts to wear off, you start to see the color spread. Can you see that a little bit? If you look closely on the camera, you can see those colors are spreading. The orange starting to turn the water orange, yellow turning it yellow, and so on as you go around the plate with the different colors. Now, we can watch this over time. It really takes a good 5 to 10 minutes before you really see the full effect. And so that'll just continue to kind of happen. But I'm already seeing right here on these edges where the red, the green, and the purple meet, there's a very distinct line right there from the red to the green and from the red to the purple where those colors actually collide, but they don't mix. They stay separated. And you'll see that now here with the yellow and the orange as well, and even the orange and the purple. As these colors continue to expand, you'll see those very distinct lines where it stays separated, kind of making that very beautiful rainbow appearance on the plate. The reason for that has to do with the wax that I mentioned. There's about four layers on each Gobstopper of colors and flavors, and between each layer, there's also a thin layer of wax. And when that wax dissolves into the water, it still acts as a barrier to kind of help protect those colors from mixing as much. So as you can see, that wax took a while to break down. There was those barriers that it kind of created from the colors spreading together, mixing together. But as I put my finger into the water, kind of swirled it around, kind of helped speed up that process. Eventually, those colors do start to mix in a little bit more. But there's also another variation we can do with this experiment that may speed up that process a little bit more. And that involves adding hot water instead of the room temperature water. So let's go ahead and try that. Okay, so now I am back with a fresh, clean plate. We've cleared off those old Gobstoppers in the water. We now have our new Gobstoppers on the plate. I didn't have enough orange. I ran out of orange this time, but it's still gonna give us the same reaction. But we're going to use hot water now, which actually might make it a little bit more exciting. So let's go ahead and pour this hot water on. Remember, we used the room temperature water the first time. I'll fill this up to about halfway, covering the candies again. Cover the bottom half of the candy. And you can already see pretty quickly the purple one is already starting to spread the colors pretty quick as we do that. The reds, the yellows, the greens, I'm now slowly starting to see that color start to expand. So I can already tell that what's happening with the hot water is happening a lot quicker. That reaction is occurring faster than what it did when we used just the room temperature water. And I'm sure many of you could probably guess why that is. Basically comes down to hot water has a lot more energy in it, and that heat is able to dissolve the wax coating on the outside of the gobstoppers quicker, and that allows the color to start escaping and running into the different colors a lot quicker as well. One thing that is still the same though, is there is still that line. You can still see a line really defining the green versus the purple. You're starting to see that with the yellow and the green running together, and the yellow and the reds as well. So the wax still does its thing by separating those colors for a little bit, but it does start to happen a lot quicker eventually as time goes. If you thought this was pretty cool, I think it's pretty fascinating myself, but you can find out more information. We kind of go into more science behind these experiments on our website. You can check that out. And then also, please don't forget to hit that subscribe button, like our stuff, follow us on social media, and that way you won't miss any more of the fun experiments that we do in the future. Thanks again, and have a great day, and we'll see you next time.